Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, in today's video, we are going to see how the Wedler current source can be helped as a current source circuit. For that purpose, we are going to derive the current relationship for the same circuit and why the Wedler current source are used as a current source circuit. So let's begin with the topic. We know that the current source circuit having a relationship, that is IO is equals to I reference. That means the output current is approximately equals to the reference current. But when we consider the two transistor circuit, and if I required the output current as, for example, 10 microampere, and if the value of VCC and VEE are given as 1 can be find out as. So if the output current of 10 microampere is required, then the resistor R1 is required to be a 930 kiloohms, which is a very large value of resistor. Such a large value of resistors are difficult to fabricate on the integrated circuit because it requires a larger area. Therefore, it is very much important to limit the range of resistor values so that they can be easily fabricated on the chip. This requirement is satisfied by using a circuit called as Wedler current source circuit. The Wedler current source circuit provides a limitation on the value of resistors so that they can be easily fabricated on the chip format. Now in case of Wedler current source, we can see that the value of VBE1 is always less than VBE2. This is because of the voltage drop across a resistor RE. So we can say that VBE1 is less than VBE2. Because of this, the value of output current, that is IO, is always less than the reference current. That is, IO is also less than I reference. In case of Wedler circuit, we can say IB1 is not equals to IB2 and IC1 is also not equals to IC2. Because of this asymmetrical values of base and collector current, the Wedler circuit is also called as current lens circuit rather than current mirror circuit. Now let's derive the current relationship for the Wedler circuit. For that purpose, we need to consider two assumptions. The first assumption that we require to consider both the transistor, that is Q1 and Q2, are ideal transistors and they have equal characteristics. Also, the beta of both the transistor is required to be very large. Now let's derive the current relationship. For that purpose, we need to consider the circuit diagram again. For considering the Wedler circuit, we require to apply KVL to the loop, which consists of VBE2, VBE1, IERE and VEE. So let's apply KVL to this loop. So the equation becomes, now we know that the emitter current is nothing but the sum of base current and collector current. Therefore, we can say that IE1 is equals to IB1 plus IC1. Therefore, we can write now from this we obtain a relationship as VBE2 minus VBE1 is equals to IB1 plus IC1 into RE. Let's consider this as equation number one. Now, if we want the collector current in terms of saturation current, then the equation becomes IC is equals to IS into e raised to VBE upon VT, where IS is the saturation current, that is reverse saturation current, and VT is voltage equivalent of temperature. Now, the same equation can be applicable for transistor Q1 and transistor Q2, and we can write the collector current IC1 and IC2 as now let's divide IC1 by IC2. In this equation, we are using term IS only because both the transistors are identical and equally match with each other. Therefore, we can say IS1 is equals to IS2 is equals to IS. Therefore, the term IS is get cancelled and the equation becomes. Now, as we require to find out the value of VB2 minus VB1, let's take the reciprocal of the equation. Therefore, the equation becomes IC2 upon IC1 equals to e raised to VBE2 upon VT divided by e raised to VBE1 upon VT. The same equation can be represented as now let's take log on both the sides. Now if we rearrange the equation, we obtain the value of VBE2 minus VBE1 is equals to VT log IC2 upon IC1. Now if we compare the equation with equation number 1, then we come to know that VBE2 minus VBE1 value is also equals to the value present in equation 1, that is VBE2 minus VBE1, which is equals to IB1 plus IC1 into RE. Now let's substitute this value in the equation 2. As we know, the base current is always less than the collector current. Therefore, we can easily neglect the base current and the equation becomes now, if we look at the circuit diagram, then we will come to know that IC2 is nothing but the reference current and IC1 is equals to output current. Therefore, instead of IC1 and IC2, we can write IO and I reference respectively. Therefore, the equation becomes as IC1 is equals to I0 and IC2 is equals to I reference. So this equation gives current relationship of output current. So this is how we can obtain the current relationship for Wedler circuit. So I hope you understand the topic of Wedler circuit and how to draw its current relationship from the circuit. So thank you very much for watching this video. Stay tuned to Ikeda. Subscribe Ikeda. Thank you.